Hello, my name is Matthew Howard, and this video is going to be a little bit different than the other videos you may have seen. In this video, I will attempt to explain why I think that the design decisions of the Chia blockchain lead themselves to strengths for certain financial uses. It's no secret that the Chia blockchain is designed a little bit differently than other blockchains. It's sometimes hard to explain why these design changes are good. In this video, I will stay away from some of the technical details in favor of high-level understanding of thinking patterns for Chia smart applications. But in order to understand what Chia does differently, firstly, we must look at what everybody else is doing. The smart contract model is the standard for most blockchains. On these blockchains, smart contracts exist as primary entities that you can interact with. You send a transaction to a smart contract, and your transaction will contain some data. The smart contract will have some state and some programmed functions, and it will receive your transaction, and some cranks will turn internally, change some stuff. Maybe you'll get some data back. That's fundamentally how it works. Smart contracts are these first class entities, but this leads to centralized design patterns. You can see in this illustration here, everyone's talking to one smart contract. And there's a problem with this, because let's say that one smart contract is just tracking a number, and everyone's sending information that's going to change this number. Plus 10 times 2 plus 4 divided by 3. Now, obviously, the order that those go in is going to affect what the final number inside of the smart contract is. So a motivated party can selfishly arrange the order that these transactions go in for their own profit. We call this minor extracted value, and smart contract-based systems are very susceptible to this kind of transaction order fidgeting. Other problems with the smart contract model include the fact that money is not a primary object. It's a secondary piece of data to transaction data. And thirdly, the smart contracts are points of centralization. Most blockchains run off this model, but Chia does not. Chia instead runs on the smart coin model. This works by having money be the primary object, and each coin contains a program. When you spend a coin, you run the program. This is resistant to transaction order fidgeting because coins can only be spent once. It's decentralized because people aren't interacting with one smart contract, they're interacting with their own local coins, and applications are built with this more decentralized approach. I'll go on to explain. Because each coin contains a program that controls what happens when it's spent, the granularity of systems is at the coin level, where each person controls their own coins. Instead of writing smart contracts about data, you instead ask yourself, for my application, what rules should govern the money? And this is a very fundamental way of thinking about things that is different in Chia. What rules govern this money? When you set out to design something in Chia, you will be constantly asking yourself that question. A good example is tokens. There are lots of different kinds of tokens with lots of different rules, but at a high level, they're implemented like this. With smart contracts, the smart contract will exist with a complete list of the tokens for that kind of token, and it will contain data for who owns each of those tokens, who has permissions to do what, and what should happen when one of those tokens is spent. This means that ownership is more like being registered on this centralized smart contract, and it's just a piece of data. With smart coins, though, you simply create a coin that contains a program that represents the token. The coin is the token in a primary tangible way. And if you want to spend that coin and give that token away, all you have to do is interact with the token coin. It's very direct and straightforward. Another example of the strengths of this coin model is financial uses. Because we're thinking in terms of what rules govern this money, for financial applications, Chia is very strong. You can write coins very simply that have this money can only be accessed if, this money is free to be spent except for. this is a strength of Chia. It is thinking about money in this way and writing programs in this way is very natural to how you design with Chia and Chialisp. Next is ownership. Another feature that the coin model supports strongly is layers of rules. This is a little complicated and I'm at risk of getting too technical for this video, but one of the ways you can write programs inside of a coin in Chia is, as long as this coin is definitely doing blank, I don't care, let the owner put whatever other rules they want. And this can be nested plenty of times. So here's a fairly complex example, where at the top level, it's saying 2 weeks must have passed since this coin was created, and then whatever other rules people want to put in. And then there could be another layer that says, another coin with the same program as me must have been spent at the same time, but after that, I don't care. Whatever other rules want to be imposed, not my problem. So then maybe Alice gets this and says, well, I don't really care what happens as long as I sign off on it. As long as I sign off on it, I don't care what other rules there are. And then beneath that, Bob, who is the final owner of this, says, I must sign off on the spend. And these are all nested, so they are all true. And you have this independence of layers. But what this means is, when you own a coin, you can impose layers of rules of program. You can put complex programs inside coins that you own. When you have a token in Chia, it's not just a registration on a smart contract. You can program it. You can put rules into it. The sense of ownership is much stronger. The downside to the coin model is that the natural representation of data and state is a little bit different. Everything is coins. So when you build systems, you have to have this coin-first approach. That can be a strength as well, because by making coins the primary object, systems are inherently decentralized. Imagine a system where you want someone to have an identity or sign up slash membership. In a smart contract, this again would be a sign up transaction you'd have to make. You'd have to inform the smart contract to be aware of you and go through this point of centralization. In the coin model, you can simply create a coin that follows the rules, that has the identity format. This is much more decentralized and it's much stronger in terms of the intrinsic value of that identity is inside of it, rather than being delegated to a smart contract that exists somewhere else. And once you have your identity, that's just one layer on the diagram that you can mix and match. So here's another diagram for an example cat token. So this is inspired by a famous cat token, but maybe in Chia cat tokens, you can have the layer that enforces the rules. It must be a valid cat token, but then they don't care what happens underneath, as they can have programmable rules inside of that. Alice can put in any rules she likes, as long as it's following that cat coin token rule set layer above. Another strength you've probably heard us talk about with Chia is sandboxing and auditability. We often say that Chia has strong sandboxing and auditability. This is because the scope of a program only ever exists inside of a coin, which is only ever spent exactly one time. This makes it easy to trace the results of transactions. You can easily follow where money goes and what happens as a result of a transaction. There's no malleability, there's no fidgeting. It's much more direct. This approach also does not have bugs like reentrancy because a coin spend is atomic. It has either happened or it has not happened. This presentation has been fairly fast and fairly high level, but it should get you thinking about this coin-first approach, this what rules lock up this money? How can I build systems that use money as the primary object? The coins themselves are smart. And once you get your head around this way of thinking, the strengths should start coming to you. Later videos in this series will explore how to actually do technical challenges, but hopefully this video will have whet your appetite and get your mind racing about the potential of the Chia ecosystem. Thank you.